cases of COVID-19.
COVID-19 pandemic.
Corona.
Coronavirus case.
California seeing a 2-week jump in cases.
COVID-19.
Coronavirus.
Hundreds were arrested in ongoing protests over police shootings.
Redemption for Golden State. One of the great playoff runs of all time is complete.
We're down over 16%.
The Supreme Court ruling on the Dreamers, blocking President Trump's plan to end the program.
A statewide emergency as those potentially historic winds fuel multiple wildfires.
With all the challenges this country faces right now, nobody can tell you, no, you're too young to understand, or this is how it's always been done. Because with so much uncertainty, with everything suddenly up for grabs, this is your generation's world to shape.
Greetings to all families, staff, and fellow graduates. I never expected to deliver a speech, but here we are, and here I am. Unfortunately, this is just the reality we have to go through right now. Even though the circumstances for us haven't been the greatest, I am honored to have the opportunity to deliver this speech to you all. To Kennedy High's powerful class of 2020, I would like to congratulate each one of you for running and winning this 4-year race, which is high school. You've reached the finish line, and you're all celebrating this accomplishment by graduating. You've all kept your heads held high throughout this journey. I know most of us had thoughts about the day we'd finally be done with high school and get on with our lives, myself included. But as we say goodbye to Kennedy, it is essential to not lose sight of the experiences we've had in high school. Remember the laughs we've all shared in class, the last minute cramming before our test started, and of course, the people and friends we've met along the way. Believe it or not, our 4 years of high school will play a big part in how we'll cope with the rest of our lives. Looking back at that very first day of freshman year, I was so nervous. I couldn't find my first period class, and the ringing of the tardy bell only added more stress to me. Luckily, there was a friendly adult who directed me to where I was supposed to go. Like that first day, the journey hasn't been easy for any of us. We have faced and overcome so many challenges. As the years passed, the stresses got bigger and the hurdles got higher. But we did not confront them alone. It would have been impossible to get through high school without the people in our lives to help guide us in the right direction. I would like to take the time to say thank you to all teachers and staff I've gotten to know who ensure students are obtaining support and getting the encouragement needed to succeed. You've kept up with us and seen past negative beliefs held towards Kennedy High students. Thank you to families who have done their best to support their children in the path of success and always believe they have the ability to achieve something great in their lives. Thank you to my family for showing me endless love and support throughout my journey in high school and beyond. I'm very happy to make you all proud as a first generation college student. Thank you, Brittany, Giselle, and Sandra, for showing me the definition of true friendship based on your wondrous actions. Because of your presence by my side, I've been able to get to this moment, making the speech for our graduation. I wish we had the opportunity to share our final moments of senior year at school. I wish that history did not have other plans for us. But let us not be sad about the moments we did not have. Instead, let us celebrate the moments we did have and look forward to the future. We should all be proud of our achievement here today. And as we now welcome this new chapter of our lives, we do so with open arms, open hearts, and open minds. Congratulations to the John F. Kennedy High School Class of 2020, and thank you.
I'm school board member, Mr. Phillips. On behalf of the school board, I would like to congratulate you on your high school graduation. This definitely wasn't an easy school year. On top of the usual challenges, you were faced with a global pandemic that forced us to close schools and move classes online. Nevertheless, you persisted. That makes you more than a high school graduate. That makes you a conqueror. Now, it's time to take that same conquering spirit into the world. We need you now more than ever. America is ablaze. Why? Because some people simply refuse to respect our humanity. But you have the power to do something about that. You have God-given gifts and talents. I charge you to use those gifts and talents in the fight for racial and social justice. You are the next generation of lawyers, politicians, activists, local, state, and national leaders. Show up and show out, Kennedy Eagles. I'm counting on you to use your mind, heart, and voice to fight for all of us. Class of 2020, I salute you.
Graduates, family, friends, and staff. I am honored to have the opportunity to address the class of 2020. It's hard to think that only 4 years ago we were freshmen. Through things like absent teachers or schedule changes, we went through it together. And look at us now, graduates of 2020. So I applaud you all for making it this far. When your friends are as goaded as mine, it's hard not to succeed. I couldn't fail even if I wanted to. They are the most supportive, driven, reliable people I've had the pleasure of knowing. Whether they be new or longtime friends. We didn't know what was going to happen, but we knew we would do it together. I am truly fortunate to know them. I'd also like to thank all the staff for their effort they've put into this school year, especially the teachers. There are teachers, and then there are teachers like Bader and Locke. They don't just feed you information. They want to make sure you've digested and understood it before moving on. It's teachers like this that make the difference in a student's educational path. They are the silent heroes. When you have examples of such upstanding adults around you, it's hard not to admire them, to notice the dedication they have and want the same for yourself. So don't forget to thank your teachers for their commitment. This pandemic was definitely not in mind when we thought of 2020. We've heard that we are in uncertain times, but one thing is for sure. All of the hard work and amount of effort I've seen you put into your schoolwork. I've seen all the preparation and last minute work spent doing assignments. I've seen how much you guys care about your schoolwork. The thoughtfulness and creativity in class projects never cease to amaze me. You guys have so much unrealized potential, and it's time you used it. Take this same determination you have and hold on to it. Continue to use it in what you decide to pursue. If you do so, you will surely succeed. As we move on from here, don't forget to cherish this moment. Be proud of your accomplishments, big or small. We don't always make the best choices, but we learn from them. Sometimes it took a couple of times before a lesson was learned, but you learned. And that's just a part of life. You live and you learn. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey there, Eagles. I'm Cent Marshall, CEO of the NBA Dallas Mavericks. I'm also a very proud graduate of John F. Kennedy High School in Richmond, California. I just dropped by in my red and white with my Eagle friend here to say congratulations. Normally, of course, I would wear blue, but in your honor, I had to put on the mighty red and white for my mighty Eagles. I am so proud of all of you. In spite of everything that we have going on in this country right now, you made it to the finish line. You could have been distracted. You could have just said, forget it. My graduation is not turning out the way I thought it would. But instead, you stayed focused, you weeded out the distractions, and you made it to the finish line. I think most of you probably said, nothing can stop us. We're going all the way up. And that is true. Nothing can stop you. One of my favorite books to give out this time of year is by Dr. Seuss. It's entitled, Oh, the Places You'll Go. And that's what I want to tell you. You are going places. You are getting ready to do big things. Some of you are going to college. Some of you are going to the military. Some of you are going to go immediately to work. Whatever it is, you are ready. John F. Kennedy High School has prepared you for your next phase of life. I want to leave you with four words that I believe got me from John F. Kennedy High School through Berkeley, through my career at AT&T, and now here with the Dallas Mavs. Those words are dream, focus, pray, and act. Have big dreams, always focus and weed out the distractions. Pray to whomever you pray to or whatever you pray to when things get tough. And then when you do all that, take action. Big things are awaiting you on this other side of graduation. God bless you. Nothing can stop us. We're going all the way up. Congratulations. Go Mighty Eagles.
Class of 2020. On behalf of the faculty and staff at Kennedy High School, I want to congratulate you for achieving this important milestone. And while it isn't the graduation ceremony you had hoped for, we are nonetheless proud of your accomplishments at this time. You're leaving high school during an extraordinary time, a time that is not only defined by the COVID-19 pandemic, but a time that has unfortunately recently been defined by unrest and frustration about how young women and men of color are being treated in our country. But you actually began your time as high school students during a similar period of frustration. Remember that fall of 2016? A new president was elected, and you, like other students across the country, expressed your frustration through protesting. So while your beginning and ends are marked by these interesting times, we know that between then, you've been doing some great things. During your time at Kennedy, your class has experienced many awesome moments. The athletes, activists, mock trial team members, musicians, scholars, historians, scientists, engineers, and technologists of the class of 2020 have already been making a lot of important contributions on campus and in the community. But we know there's so much more to come. So as you enter into that future, I want to take a moment to connect how our school-wide expectations are actually connected to the real world. Since many times students always ask the question, why are we learning this? Being respectful, particularly as you interact with a variety of people in college, on your jobs, or in the military, is so important and it will always be the right thing to do. Our diverse community demands that we respect everyone, regardless of where they come from, who they love, what language they speak, and where they live. Sometimes you have to show respect even if you don't get it. And I know that that's really difficult, but I guarantee you it's the right thing to do and it pays off. Being responsible, as many of you are taking on new challenges during this pandemic, whether you're working or working more hours, you're taking care of members of your family, or you're doing other things to support them, shows that you care and that you're willing to help others. We know that many of you and your families have had their lives negatively impacted by COVID-19. We just want you to know how much we appreciate you for supporting your family and your community during this time. That's being responsible. And finally, being engaged means, above all things in this year, registering to vote if you're eligible to do so and actually showing up to vote. But you can also not just vote for president this year, but for elected officials at the state and local level, including our school board. You can also be engaged by advocating for things that your community needs to survive and thrive during this pandemic and beyond. And you can be engaged by making a personal commitment to do your best in whatever path you choose after leaving Kennedy. I too am leaving Kennedy, and I want to thank you, class of 2020, for allowing me to support you over these last 2 years during your journey. So, as you leave Kennedy, I hope you'll remember, once an Eagle, always an Eagle. Now that you're moving from students to alumni, I want you to continue to share with us your successes. Keep in touch, contact the office, visit our social media pages, let us know how you're doing. Congratulations on achieving this moment of success, class of 2020, and we look forward to hearing more about your successes in the future. Congratulations.
Now, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Education of the West Contra Costa Unified School District and the State of California, I hereby certify that the graduates seated before me have met all requirements for graduation of the West Contra Costa Unified School District and the State of California, and I hereby accept them as graduates of the class of 2020. Congratulations.
We'll be right back. Hi, everybody. Steve Kerr from the Golden State Warriors. I wanted to take this opportunity to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Everyone in the Bay Area is extremely proud of you and your accomplishment, especially under such difficult circumstances over the past several months. As any coach would tell you, you're going to face a lot of adversity at some point in the game, or in this case, in life. And to persevere through that adversity is really what's going to set you apart and make you a champion. You guys have crossed the first hurdle, should be really commended for that. And I just want to say congratulations again. Go make the Bay Area proud.
Greetings, everyone. Bob Myers with the Golden State Warriors. First of all, I wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Outstanding work by each and every one of you. All the long days, homework, and study hall are in the past. Now, you can focus on the future. And as we have experienced over the last year, the future might have its bumps and bruises. But regardless of what is thrown in your direction, and the road will not always be straight and perfect, stay positive and plug forward. You too can be a champion. Congrats again, and go strive for greatness.
What's going on, everyone? It's Juan Toscano Anderson of the Golden State Warriors, Cache Valley High alum, class of 2011. I myself am also from the Bay Area, and it doesn't seem like 9 years ago when I graduated, but regardless of how long it's been since I was in your shoes, congratulations to this year's graduates, the class of 2020. Although with everything that's going on, I understand you guys can be a little discouraged and trying to figure out what's going to happen next in your life. Just stay positive. You know, things will pass over. Keep your goals there. Keep your dreams there. Follow them. Do whatever you want. Do whatever you put your minds to. I myself never thought that I would be in the NBA. And just like you guys, I'm also from the Bay Area. So if I can do it, you guys can do it as well. I encourage you guys to continue to stay positive and just continue to stay persistent. Stay safe, stay healthy. And if you really want to do it right, follow it in this guy's next steps.
Hey, everybody. Stephen Curry here from the Golden State Warriors. Congratulations to the Bay Area class of 2020. You guys did it. And you did it under some pretty unique and uncertain circumstances, to say the least. So congratulations. Now it's time to go out and conquer the world. As the last few months have taught everybody, expect the unexpected, be able to adapt, but don't let anything stand in your way. I'm a firm believer in the mantra, I can do all things, and I hope you are too. So now it's time to go and live that out every single day. Congratulations again. We got you. Rooting for you guys. All the support and love. Peace.